Hey runners, Wrinkled Runner here. So today it is time for an update to the most popular video on my YouTube channel. The last time I did a tutorial for the Intervals app was 2 years ago, and there have been some changes for the better in my opinion. So let's jump. If you tuned into my last video on this app, you saw that it is before I knew about screen recording. So now that I'm a little more savvy on that aspect of tech tutorials, this one should be much easier to see and understand. So if you're watching this video, you're probably wanting to incorporate some speed work into your running. Workouts like these help your fitness, and if you keep it up, you're going to end up with faster times. Note though that you don't always want your runs to be stressful runs. Most should be pretty easy. Long runs, intervals, other speed work, running hills, all those are runs that stress your body. And if you overdo it, it's going to lead to injury and burnout. You can find videos where I talk about those things in the description box below. So check those out if you need a little more detail on what I'm talking about. Note about the app itself, I use the pro version, so some of the things I will show you will only apply to that. The free version only allows you to set up one timer, so you won't be able to store like different ones, and you'll have to reset the intervals up each time if you won't be doing the same thing. So here is the Intervals Pro icon, and we're going to tap that, and it shows you the list of timers that we have. And like I said before, I have the Intervals Pro edition, and so I have all of my timers that I have done. And just to show you an example, if you hit that one, that means we're going to run 600 meters 8 times with a 400 meter recovery walk after each of the 600 meter runs. So it's a custom timer, and you can see it's 3 minutes plus 5 miles, 5.72 miles. And it's running, and this gives you a preview of the whole thing. So for example, if you only wanted to do 4 instead of 8, you could hit the number 5, and then it'll just go through the last 4 of them, and so then that's what you would be able to do. But to start it, you could just hit the start button, and it'll show you this, and it'll be on your phone, and you can pause it, resume it, you know, whatever you want to do with that one. I'll show you later how it works. On the Apple Watch. So we're not going to save this one. We're going to just discard it, and then we're going to be back to the timers thing. So what we want to do right now is add a custom timer and add a new one. So we're going to hit the blue button down there. And the first thing I want to show you actually is they do have some workout templates here. They have a training program, 5K training program, None to Run, which is a 12-week running plan for beginners. And then they have all these other different workouts that you can see, run, walk, workout, open run, all these different things. But what we're going to do right now is do a custom interval timer. So we're going to hit add. We're going to hit new timer, and we're going to call it YouTube run. Done. And you need to select the activity type, and it is a running workout. And so then we're done. So then that automatically switches everything from here to the outdoor and walk run. And you can disable fitness tracking. You can see if you want to use the Apple Watch workout app or another fitness app at the same time. So the intervals will not track fitness data when enabled. So if you wanted to use your watch to show the workout, you would just hit disable fitness tracking. And then the phone, the app itself won't record it, but your Apple Watch will. Okay, so we're going to go back because it's running, and we're going to hit interval 1. And you can call it something if you want. I'm just going to call it run. And we're going to do the duration. Now we're going to be doing distance over time. And we're going to run for miles. And we're going to run, say, half a mile for that duration.
Now, the continue after duration means that you would just, here, I'll show you the information on it. It counts down to the estimated duration and then counts up until you manually advance to the next interval. I need as few things to do as possible, so I never hit that. I just let it go into the walk interval. So text to speech is the alert that I use, and you can pick other things if you want, a gong, you know, starting pistol, all those other things. But mine just says, you know, 5 minutes or 5 seconds to start. Halfway alert, if you want to be notified, in this case, it would be at the quarter mile mark. And repeat count is going to be none, because I'm not going to repeat this after this one, which is, I know, confusing, but after this half mile, I want to walk for a quarter of a mile. And then I'm going to go into another run, but that is a cycle.
One thing, if you do a lot of workouts and you're running at a particular pace, or you want to run at a particular pace, this app allows you to set a pace so that you can be alerted whether you're running too fast or too slow. Different running workouts will have you run like at your 5K pace or half marathon pace, or, you know, your marathon pace plus 10 seconds, or, you know, different workouts will tell you to do different things. So this will allow you to set those paces. I personally suck at pacing, and so this is excellent for me to be able to be notified if I'm running something too fast or too slow. And I don't have it too much, like I usually do something like this, like a 15 second target pace. You don't want it to be constantly letting you know, like if it's only like if you want to run a 9:30 and say you set the maximum at like a 9:33, it's just going to annoy the heck out of you, because it's going to notify you every 2 seconds that you're going too fast or too slow. So this gives it more of a give, and allows you then to stay within that 15 second range, which helps you to stay on target, and it also helps you to learn your paces. So for interval two, we're going to call it the walk, and we're going to do distance again, mileage, and we're going to walk for a quarter of a mile. And we're gonna have everything set up the same, and we're gonna go back. And then you could add another interval if you wanted to, if you wanted to do something different. And you could, you know, if you're going to run then a mile and then walk half a mile, something like that, you would add those kinds of intervals here. So you can do that. Now, number of cycles, that is telling you how many times you're going to do the run for half and the walk for a quarter. So we're gonna do the 4 cycles. So now it's 4 cycles. So that will do run, walk, run, walk, run, walk, run, walk. So 4 times for those intervals. Down here, we're going to include a warm up, and that's going to be duration. And we'll do a 5 mile or 5 minute warm up. And we'll do a cool down. And we'll do that for, we'll say 5 minutes. Now, a lot of times I don't use the cool down, because since this is like a run walk, I'm already walking at the end for a quarter of a mile. So you don't really need to add any more than that, but just for the sake of showing you the warm up and cool down section, that's what we're going to do. This will count down that you have 5 seconds remaining, and it will tell you, it will speak to you, your phone will speak to you and say, okay, you know, 5 seconds until interval two, or 5 seconds until interval one, where it goes back and forth. You can also do a target heart rate and, you know, pick whatever number. I don't have very much trouble with my heart rate getting too high, but some people do. So, you know, say you know that you start to feel really yucky if your heart rate is at 160, you could have your minimum at, well, I would have your maximum be at 160. And if you got that high, then you need to stop and have your minimum say at 150, just to alert you that you are getting into danger range and you're not gonna be doing too well if you keep it up. Okay, so that set up the timer, the cycles, the intervals. Apple Watch settings,
you will, it just shows you, like, you can have a 5 second countdown for a haptic, and it'll just, you know, bop you on the wrist. And you can have a time and distance goal. And if you reach your goal, then it will tell you. So the most important thing when you're doing a interval timer like this is to hit the save button up here. A lot of times I have found that I forgotten to hit the save button, and then I cannot figure out why I don't have it in here. But it is definitely important that you hit that save button.
You can also tell the app to, if you want the headphone, if you have the headphones on, that it will talk to you then. So even though it's coming through the speakers on the watch, it will go through the headphones as well. So you can choose what taps on the watch will bring up different information, such as your workout status, or to pause or to resume the interval. So this was a quicker tutorial on the app. There's actually a longer explanation with more pictures over at wrinkledrunner.com, and I'll link up to that post down below. It's a little more helpful to be able to read through what you're supposed to do and see the actual pictures with the arrows and all that stuff, than for me to go over everything that's about the app, which I did over at the post. If you have any questions about this app that aren't answered either here or on the Wrinkled Runner website, you can comment down below or send me an email at sherry@wrinkledrunner.com. I'm always looking for topics to help people with, so if you have any questions, I'd be interested in hearing from you. You can link up over to the website to find out what's going on over there and sign up for the once a month newsletter. It's the first Saturday of each month, and I talk about all the different things that are going over either on the YouTube channel or on Facebook or at the wrinkledrunner.com website. I always am free to answer questions through email, and we'll get back to you if you email me a question about your running or about training or whatever it is that you have a question about. Next week's topic is going to be about starting running, and I always recommend a Couch to 5K run walk program that is put out by the RRCA, or the Road Runners Club of America. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the run.